Patient CM, an elderly male with colon cancer, had a bowel resection surgery. Postoperatively, he gradually deteriorated. Today, he was febrile, had severe abdominal pain, his white count was elevated, and he looked very sick. CM went back to the OR for a washout and repair of an anastomotic leak. He is now in the ICU. CM has secondary peritonitis. Secondary peritonitis is defined as spillage of normal gut flora into the peritoneum. Intra-abdominal infections are categorized by the extent, localized or extending beyond the initial site of infection, onset, community or hospital, and severity of infection. Severe disease can involve comorbidities, shock, immunosuppression, older age, an APACHE 2 score of more than 15, and organ dysfunction. Clinical presentation of secondary peritonitis includes abdominal pain with rigidity or guarding, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea or constipation, fever, chills, and rigors. Imaging studies are useful to visualize sites of infection. Community-acquired peritonitis is caused by normal gut flora. In hospital-acquired peritonitis, also considered difficult to treat nosocomial organisms. Cultures are only recommended in hospital-acquired infections or severely ill patients, as gut flora are relatively predictable. Empiric therapy should cover core pathogens and account for severity of infection, local resistance patterns, prior antibiotic exposure, and possible resistant organisms. Anti-enterococcal antibiotics in mild to moderate community-acquired infections don't alter outcomes. In severe infections, empiric therapy should include anti-enterococcal activity, particularly for those with prior exposure to broad-spectrum antibiotics, liver transplant patients, and patients with valvular heart disease and prosthetic devices. For CM, a broad-spectrum antibiotic, such as piperacillin tazobactam, is reasonable. If difficult-to-treat or problem bugs are not found in cultures, narrow the antimicrobial coverage. Regardless of antibiotics, adequate source control, such as abscess drainage or intra-abdominal washout, is crucial to resolution of infection. Once source control is achieved, duration of antibiotics is guided by infection complexity. For uncomplicated community-acquired intra-abdominal infections, such as non-perforated appendicitis, only surgical prophylaxis is needed. Complicated infections require 4 to 7 days of therapy if the patient is stable and improving. Conversely, for a patient who does not improve, rather than prolonging the course of antibiotics, reassess for source control. Key messages: target therapy to normal gut flora, consider risk factors for problem bugs, duration of therapy is typically 4 to 7 days after achieving source control, and clinical deterioration warrants further investigation rather than more antibiotics.